It was like a really intense thing, and it was really hard to get over it. And I realized it was not so much the person, it was like that I felt really broken as a person, and I was like really lost in my 20s. And just like, I didn't like what I saw in the mirror, and the moment this person kind of exited the picture, I had no choice but to face that. And so then that started becoming this thing where I wanted to make a movie about being lost in my 20s. And so this short is just, it's a proof of concept for the feature that we're making right now.
Oh, great. Yeah, I thought you really captured that really well. And I thought it was interesting also that, you know, it took place in Seoul, and the gay scene in Korea is a little bit sort of, you know, it's sort of there, but it's not as open as it is in the U.S. So,
yeah.
Did you have, to say the least, right? Did you have, were there any conflicts or any struggles that you had because you were, you know, sort of thematically about that for your short in Korea?
Do you mean like while making it or just?
Or just kind of like writing it, getting people involved, you know, do you have any, or did you have any other creative hurdles?
Yeah, I mean, obviously it's like, it's an independent film, and I put all my own money into it, and to make it, you know, you just kind of have to believe in it more than everyone else, and so, like, it took me a long time to just, like, write it and think that it was worth it to actually make it, and that was, like, a struggle, but then I'd already known a few people, like, I was directing music videos, and I directed a short, another feature, like, in 2011, so I kind of had enough of a crew that trusted me and wanted to do it. So, yeah, the hardest thing to find was like Dean, who's the guy at the end that he meets by the river. I had no idea I couldn't find anyone, and we were like coming down to the wire, and I still had I had no one in that role, and I was like, "Dear Lord, it's the whole second half of the film, and it's like there's no characters." And then just randomly it all came together and ended up working out.
Yeah, well, it's really a great film, and it's short. And I guess it kind of it ends with sort of leading into this potential there. So is that what your future is going to be, just extending upon?
Yeah, it's just like what happens when they meet again randomly, like a few weeks later. And it's just about how two people from different places in the world fall in love in the middle of Korea and then fall apart. And we all wake up and realize like we have to kind of grow up and go home.
Yeah. Well, we can't wait to look forward to the final film.
It'll be a while.
Does anyone in the audience have a question for the director or the director star?
Yes. I have a comment. I love it. Start to finish. It was awesome.
Thank you. Sure. Ultra Blue is, it's an homage to like one of my favorite Japanese pop singers, Utada Hikaru, and her fourth album is called Ultra Blue. And I just knew a lot about her as a person, and I knew that as an artist, she was always working, and she ended up marrying her music video director, and her life was like very much about work, and she couldn't meet people, and she found this guy. And then ultimately it didn't work out, and I just could relate to the idea of like you're always working and you tend to meet people like where you're working. And when it didn't work out for her, she made this album called Ultra Blue, and I always thought that it was just such an interesting way to express that, what that must feel like. And when I was dealing with it myself, that was the only thing I imagined calling it. And then in terms of the film, it's kind of like the first half of the film is just that feeling of how intense it is, and when you're angry or upset or kind of like torn apart and you feel like a hurricane, and then the next morning you wake up and it's just this house of calm, and you have to deal with like the roaring silence, and yeah, so that's
Yes, hey, you never have before.
How difficult is it to be in all those different places at once, acting, writing, directing? How do you
I've gotten that question a lot, and honestly, the short answer is, Beyonce can do it, I can do it. But the long answer is it requires like just a ton of plasting. Oh, planning.
Plasting.
I don't know that. I'm a little tired. There's a lot of whiskey.
Sorry.
It just takes a lot of planning. A lot of people have asked me, like, will I follow those roles again, like, in the future? And the answer is yes. The point of this film was that, like, I initially wanted to be an actor, and I kind of gave up on it very early because I didn't have enough courage. And I didn't want to just, like, act for the sake of acting. And this is a film that's very close to my heart, and it's very biographical. I want it to be surreal, and so I'm going to continue to do that. But it was just about preparation. It was having trust in, like, a cameraman, my DP, and having trust in my producer and my assistant director. And then on set, I didn't have to really direct, I just was acting.
Yeah, I always find it so interesting when you have the writer and the director, you know, also be the actor and the editor sometimes. And I think it's really important to have people that you trust, you know, that can give you some input and help you edit. Yeah, it's something to give you that. Any other questions from the audience? Yes?
Great film. I was a big fan of the dialogue. And my question is, how much of that was the written word on the script, and then how much was like improv or ad-lib on set?
Thank you. It was, honestly, it was about 80% written, and then I like specifically grabbed every actor, took them aside for like a few days, and just worked on the scene again and again. Hearing them, obviously when you write something, you're like, in your head, you're in a room in the dark, and you're like, oh, that sounds great. And then you're like, they try and say it, they're like, I can't say this. Like, it just doesn't roll off the tongue. And then, so I let them figure it out, and then we improvised, and then we wrote that into the script. So on set, they stuck to the script, but the script did allow for them to, like, improvise.
Any other questions?
You like enjoy it. It's really interesting. You sort of
thank you. Well, it's kind of similar to Ultra Blue. Like, the film starts like really saturated and extreme in its color palette, and then I wanted for me, like, pink is like the thematic color of the film. It's not actually blue. And I just, one, for one reason, I just, you know, there's that idea that men are blue and women are pink, like, by birth, like, you know, you're born and that's the clothes you wear and that's who you are. And, like, I just never grew up feeling that way. I felt more sensitive than a typical guy, and I just, so the color being pink in the film as a main theme is kind of like a fuck you to society. It's kind of just like, yeah, you can be pink and still be an angry fool and be violent and crazy and have to grow up. And throughout the film, we wanted it to fade and the color to get more distant. And like, so the sky at the end is like really light pink, and at the start it's like very intense, like fuchsia pink. And I just wanted this film to feel like a memory, because it's kind of how I remember a lot of those moments, and a lot of those moments did happen. And so there's like also the moments where it freezes and I like hand drew on top of the screen, because it's like all in my head. And oh yeah, remember this ratchet best friend I had in Korea, like, who slept with me on the street until morning. And it's like, yeah, so by the end of the film it's becoming more faint, because it's just, it's harder and harder to remember.
Yeah, I thought it was beautifully shot. I love these questions too, because so much insight into the movie and
good
the,
questions.
Yeah,
thank you.
The lighting. With the competition and with your feature. We have a digital jury for Kathy, and we are going to have the winner of the shorts competition announced a week from Sunday. So everyone log into Kathy.com. We're also going to be on Facebook announcing the winner.